In other news, global employment will not return to pre-COVID-19 levels until at least 2023. That is the latest outlook of the Organization for Cooperation and Economic Development, or OECD. The OECD report says the pandemic left 22 million people across industrial nations jobless last year. Now, of that number, 8 million remain unemployed to this day, while 14 million are classified as inactive. The study also highlighting the disparate impact of the pandemic to women and other vulnerable groups.
Despite support efforts from countries, the crisis has clearly hit vulnerable groups such as young people, many women, the low-skilled and frontline workers harder. Without well-targeted measures, some of these short-term effects risk becoming long-term scars. Young workers, for example, saw large reductions in their hours of work, nearly twice as much as for prime-aged and older workers at the peak of the crisis back in 2020.
China's crackdown on its tech giants continue. The latest move, China's market regulator fined a number of internet companies, including DD Global, Tencent, and Alibaba, for failing to report merger deals in advance. U.S.-listed shares of DD Choosing, the ride-hailing app, fell for a third straight day, down 4.6% to $11.91. That's already below its listing price in the U.S. DD has lost $17 billion of its market value just this week in the wake of China ordering the app to be removed from app stores as part of a broader crackdown on China-based companies with overseas listing. U.S. stocks ending higher on Wednesday as investors poured back into tech shares. The S&P 500 advancing 0.3% to a new high of 43.58. The Dow rising 104 points, while the tech-heavy Nasdaq closed flat, but just enough to notch a new record. Now, minutes from the U.S. Federal Reserve's June meeting showed, while policymakers discussed tapering, they are in no rush to start the process. The 10-year Treasury yield fell as low as 1.29% following the Fed minutes. Now, it's a different scene from last month, where investors began anticipating the Fed would move quickly to tighten its policy, prompting a sell-off and a rise in yields. Wall Street has been concerned about inflation, with investors moving between economy-linked value stocks and growth names, which are in tech stocks, in the past few sessions.
I think the market is really focused on the upcoming debt ceiling and the ramifications it's going to have for supply, especially on the bond market side of things. And that's what has driven yields down, along with the negative yielding debt we've seen spike in overseas. As far as the equity markets, I believe that the equity markets can grind higher from here because, you know, interest rates are lower. And we're almost kind of putting ourselves into a Goldilocks scenario where, you know, equities can do better and fixed income can do better at the same time.
No, it is actually on. And it's
taking a look now at U.S. stock futures, seems like a muted open there when trading resumes tonight, Manila time. Now, over here in Asia, shares are mixed in Thursday morning trade as U.S. Fed minutes showed policymakers are still waiting for more evidence of robust economic recovery before trimming bond purchases. As you can see, Japan's Nikkei 225 down 0.2%, while markets in South Korea and Australia are so far still in the green. Now, in corporate news, Goldman Sachs has secured a license to operate banks in Japan. It will offer services such as helping Japan-based multinationals with dollar funding. It is set to open an office in Tokyo by September of this year. Now, over in South Korea, we're also monitoring Hyundai, where unionized workers have voted for a possible strike for higher wages and better working conditions. Now, 74% of their 48,600 member union agreed to hold that strike unless the company accepts their demands. Now, over in Australia, a consortium led by Macquarie Group is exploring a rival offer for Sydney Airport in a potential challenge to the $22.3 billion bid of IFM investors.